So we're going to demonstrate what happens when something evaporates. So we've got some water inside the kettle, which has been pre-boiled. So we're going to boil some more, and we're going to see what happens. Okay, now the black card is there, so you'll be able to see the steam that comes out of it. But if I turn this up, see how there's liquid that's now come off it? So we had liquid, and then it evaporated and became a gas, and now it's gone back into a liquid. So evaporation is when it goes from a liquid to a gas. So does anyone know what it's called when it goes from a gas to a liquid? Turn and talk to the person next to you. Have a discussion about what you think it's called.
If we'd had a little bit more time in that session, first session, to actually have given them counters while we were looking at the steam and to think about how the particles were acting and then actually act out, oh, this is what's happening with the particles, so that it's bringing it back to the physical again.
Yeah. Well, we could have elaborated a bit more, yeah, because we were talking about evaporation and we haven't touched on that yet. So, yeah, using the counters would have been a good idea, just to cement that knowledge.
Yeah, it depends on the time too. We did want to get on to the
animations.
Yeah.
Which is the main focus at the moment anyway, now that we're sort of coming to the end of the sequence of lessons.
Now let's hark back to our last lessons. Okay, we've been animating, you've been animating, and you've been representing what we've learned so far really in a really good ways. We've been really impressed with what you've been doing.
Very impressed.
But we'd like to make sure you have a look today and have a think and see if you can take it a little bit further. Can you show a bit more detail? Can you make sure that the science that you're showing is accurate?
So we'll be using Movie Maker, and you're all aware of how to use Movie Maker. So we're going to collect the things that you've got on your webcams, on your flip cams, on the iPads, and put them into Movie Maker so you can insert like voiceovers and maybe some more information to get that extra detail that Mr. Kadush was talking about.
All right, so you need to discuss about what's happening with the red counters. So the red counters, what do they represent? Yeah, the particles and the perfume, very good. Okay, so you need to explain that. So when someone watches the movie, if they don't know anything about science, they still understand what's happening.
I really liked how they had their storyboards and their animations are actually following what they put in their storyboards. Even though their storyboards were fairly rough, it captured their ideas, which we talked about with them. And then the representation of the particle model is actually showing that they've picked up what we've been teaching them over the series of lessons. It'll be really good to pull it all together and actually see them as a whole movie with the little footage that they've shot, the animation bits they've done with their voiceovers, and putting it all together into Movie Maker and actually coming out with a finished product. Hopefully we can see some of those tomorrow.
So you've all worked extremely well during this session. We're all very impressed with the work you've done. And a lot of people have done a lot more on their animations and are very close to finishing. Okay, so the goal was to put it into Movie Maker and to start drawing all of the different movies that you've got on the flip cams and webcams all together into the one animation. How are we going? Can we see it? Okay, so we're going to press play. So there is no sound yet, but hopefully they're going to add some sound. But they have added some information there. So the blue counters represent the air particles. Look at the blue counters. The red particles are the perfume. The red particles are moving around because they are a gas, and gas particles are free to move around. See the gas particles coming in? The gas particles spread through the air until they got to the man's nose. The smell is perfume.
It's quite significant, the use of the technology. You know, a few years ago, even less, you probably wouldn't have been able to have brought all these things together, the stop motion program, the iPads, the webcams.
Well, even, the iPads, like, they're so easy to use. And at the start, all the kids are like, oh, I want to use the iPad. But then we had the two groups actually using it. But so easy, and they were so quick to do. I think the ICT aspect has also boosted this, like, amount of social interaction that's going on within the class. When you look at Jed in particular.
Jed, fantastic.
Yeah, and especially how he started off like, oh, I hate school, I don't like science, you know, I don't want to do the work.
And the first day he told me he doesn't read books. Yeah. No, I don't read books.
And now he's out there, his animation's almost finished, and he used the iPad, which I think was really, really good for him because it was so easy and so fun. Because in the lesson, his partner was away, so he was partnered up with someone else, and they still worked really, really
well together.
That was
great, and that's those social aspects and the well-being aspects of him becoming involved with other people that he probably wouldn't have if it wasn't for the the project involving the ICT and the physical things to move around, that he's really latched onto. And I don't think he would have demonstrated any sort of that amount of learning if we hadn't have been using those pieces of equipment and actually getting them to handle things and saying, well, these are like the particles. And all you can use the iPad. Here you go.